Thank you for joining me today. How are you? It is Friday, and Friday is sort of like my open discussion on different topics that's really leading, you know, the nation, and getting a lot of information on YouTube and also dialogue and, you know, personal conversations. And there are a couple of things that I just kind of wanted to bring up, maybe three things. One is I didn't get a chance to sort of talk about the different things that were taking place with the WNBA and just sort of how the landscape of that situation has played out. I am now a fan of the WNBA. Like I had mentioned before, I'm pretty supportive of all the this year's draft because, you know, I've never watched it before, but I did start to notice their names and their playing ability when we had the college conferences. So I'm very, you know, pleased to be a part of that new community. Have been enjoying the games. Have so far gone to three games, and I'm pretty impressed with the athleticism of all the women. And so just wanted to mention that since I'm kind of new to the community, and I'll make sure that I sort of add some comments every now and then. The other thing that's come up, and I added the video that I liked, was about this prophetic word that was stated a few years ago by a gentleman named Brandon. And so I'm going to talk a little bit about, you know, the prophetic word from, you know, just my little general understanding. I am not a biblical scholar. I did not go to the school of divinity, but I am a born again believer, as well as I do read every year. I do use the daily bread to go through reading scriptures every year because I like to just kind of like look at the stories, read the stories, absorb the stories, and take new information as I possibly can. And I've been doing that for 15 years. So the Daily Bread is a devotional little book that's online now that walks you through the reading of the Bible, Old Testament and New Testament, for 365 days. So that's kind of like been my approach, just making sure I read. So with this video that's come out, I've seen it, you know, I've seen different people, you know, sort of dissect it and so forth. And I'm not here to dissect it in that way, but the video that I added to this channel, to this video, I did like the gentleman because not only did he provide scripture, he used examples, which I too had written down today. And he also explained what a prophetic word is. And he also talked about how we should discern a prophetic word. And I'm not here to challenge anybody on, you know, receiving a word from the Lord. I do know what it's like to receive a word from the Lord, and that word is for you. And that word can be shared with others upon, you know, your understanding. That's what has been asked of you through the Holy Spirit. In part two of that prophetic word, I thought it was interesting that somehow there was a conversion that was mentioned with after the incident with former President Trump being shot at and had his ear injured. So prophetic word and conversion, that's my little topic today on Friday's village circle talk, one of those ways. I forget how I said it. So what are your thoughts? What came up for you? A lot of things came up for me, and I want to be respectful because I do believe in the prophetic word. But what made me think about the prophetic word was thinking about how often throughout the Old Testament and the New Testament, how people, you know, leadership went and sought out different prophetic leaders, prophetic, you know, known guides in during the state of war, during the state of unrest in the nations, during the state of, you know, feeling that they're going to be defeated and wanting to preserve their power and their leadership, and just how different kings had sought out you know, those ones who were known to know God and be led by God. And so, you know, I was just thinking of different ones, like, you know, during the time of Daniel, when they were locked in the lion's den and so forth. And after, you know, the king realized that, you know, that the men were not, you know, weren't burned to death or eaten by the lions, he stated that he wanted to know the God that these young men served. And that was King Nebuchadnezzar, then the king of Babylon. And how he deferred to these men of God with a whole lot of responsibility to help keep the nation safe and secure and under the guidance of God. And then I think about, you know, the days of Joseph when he was incarcerated with the, you know, as a result of being taken off to Egypt, and the king's wife had stated that, you know, he attempted to assault her, and how he stayed in prison for a lot of years. I mean, and in during that time, you know, his only recourse was to receive the word of God and provide, you know, prophetic words to the cupbearer and things like that. And just how, you know, when he was remembered, the king was going through a troubled time where he was distressed. And he sought, and he listened to his, when he freed his cupbearer, he listened to him and received a cup. You know, he freed Joseph, and Joseph gave him a prophetic word. And as a result, you know, the king, you know, gave Joseph leadership over a region of, in Egypt. And Joseph was able to open the doors for others to come from his nationality, Israelites, to come. And so they begin to multiply in Egypt. Then I think about the book of Esther, when she had taken off and was married to the king of that day, and her uncle Mordecai was a man of God, prophetic man of God. And during that time when the king had a military leader who wanted to, you know, kill off the Jews and so forth, and how Mordecai, her uncle Mordecai, had reached out to her and just said, don't think that just because you're in the king's palace, you also would be exempt. This may be the time for you to act on what you may have received as, you know, this may be the time for you to act on who you are and for your people. And so as a result, you know, the story about Haman and, you know, and things like that. And then at that point, the king had also lifted Mordecai up, who was a Jew, a man of God, and so forth. And so I think about in the New Testament, Paul and his conversion, it was really rough. And, you know, prior to his conversion, you know, Saul, then Paul, was really rough on Jews and so forth who believed in the resurrection Christ. And he would just jump on them and beat them up. And everybody was afraid of him. And then after his conversion, you know, he went back to those churches, those temples, those synagogues, and try to, you know, help people understand who Jesus the Lord is and his resurrection and so on and so forth. And of course, they did to him what he did to them, which was beat him up and, you know, incarcerated him, you know, and starved him and things like that. And but he continued to, you know, walk in his purpose as a new believer, which was tell those about Christ. And so with that being said, you know, I mean, I appreciate, you know, the sharing of the prophetic word. I think it's really good that in our country, we're now able to say that we are, you know, born again believers. We love the Lord, and we're also able to receive or have interactions about that. I think one of the things that, you know, that's stated in the New Testament, in which I cannot look for the scripture right now, but it's stated that, you know, to something to the effect that you need to be able to calmly state when people cross-examine you and try to persecute you and try to come for you, that you need to be able to state in a calm, loving, peaceful way why you believe and stand on what you believe and stand on. And so this is kind of like with my village circle talk today, is to say that I do believe in the prophetic word, and I do believe in conversions. And I think with conversions comes with the willingness to be born again, to be renewed, to have a renewing of your mind, and also a purification of your heart. And that's kind of like what I would be measuring, you know, things on regarding this political season. You know, prior to Biden, prior to this prophetic word, and prior to Biden, you know, having him and Trump having their first debate, I think people, you know, even people of the faith were, you know, sort of having some conversations. And like I said, I don't mind the conversations. They're, you know, we're humans. We're supposed to have real experiences about things. And however, my question was to the believers, like, are you praying? Are you praying that he, you know, are you praying for his health? Are you praying for his, you know, his support system? Are you praying that, that he continues to prevail in what he has done for the American people? And if you feel like he hasn't done anything, I mean, okay. If you feel like Harris hasn't done anything, I mean, I have to, you know, understand that that's maybe what you feel and believe. And you know, I can certainly list a lot of things here, but that's not what this Village Circle talk is about today. It's about me listing, you know, their results. But prophetic and conversion, getting a prophetic word and converting. And see, with that statement that this young man mentioned, they don't always come together, because I've gotten prophetic words and there's, you know, some of them didn't even come true, and there it was. And the only way the prophetic word is to be known to be true if it comes true, if it becomes an actuality. And so nobody knows what Trump was doing when he was kneeled down trying to hold his ear from bleeding. Only Mr. Trump knows that. However, one thing that I will say from that prophetic word and also from reading the scripture is that leaders, in what I've read, deferred to men and women who had a long standing being under the authority of the Lord. A lifelong standing being under the authority of the Lord. And for me, the way I looked at all this was the perspective from that angle, is that Mr. Trump once was the leader. Okay, and Mr. Biden is the current leader. And the one way to know if that was a conversion, if there is a seeking of those who have a long, lifelong standing under the authority of the Lord. And you will see that in based on what they do. So you can take that either way you want to take that. But I'm thankful that the word of God is being put out there, because we're supposed to be a nation that is of God, of Jesus Christ. And somehow, in some way, over time, and I'll be the first to say, we've been pushed to water it down and not to, and just make everybody feel comfortable and don't offend people. I have worked with so many people in healthcare that, you know, don't see Jesus as the Son of God. And trust me, we have gotten along perfectly fine. I used to do the prayer at one place I used to work with, and the number of people who approached me and said, thank you for your prayer, it really helped move something in me. It helped shift something in me. So I do believe, and when the word of God is spread through love, it does touch us differently. So that's enough of that. So prophetic word and conversion was what I wanted to talk about today. And I hope you enjoyed this talk. Send me something in the email or, you know, on the link. Let me know what you think. And thank you for joining me today. This is Village Circle Talk, where I'm not a therapist. I'm not a coach. I'm just chit-chatting with the community. Take care of yourself. Bye.